our most adorable, respectable doctor, Praveen sir. And I think that there is no need for any introduction to him. So Dr. Praveen Kumar sir has been a well-recognized principal and HOD of the head of the Department of Medicine in JSPC, the Government Medical College, Hyderabad. And on his cup of tea, there are many awards, and the right award you can see right forth in front of you, Dr. Hanuman. And so he has the first best award winner in 2017 from the Telangana government. As a national best award, Dr. B.K. Bose Memorial winner in 2005, and the national best teacher award, Dr. Mahendra Singh Memorial from 2014. He is a guide and examiner to many universities and has visited many, many PG institutes. And all of them must have definitely benefited from his words of wisdom over there. The most astonishing research and his biodata is to the discovered potentiality of Crotalus hor through in vitro study. And from here, the most famous personality all over India, I may say all over the globe, from the GHF, where he established his specialty clinic for HIV, AIDS. And so much patient oriented. Thank you, sir. Wow. You can share your video now.
Right. So thank you, Dr. Vaishali. Really, it was astonishing when I have seen my short journey. Anyway.
Shortest.
No. That's more than needed. You have shown, and anyway. Thanks a lot, and thanks to the NGH family and extended family also. And I should thank Dr. Aruna for presenting the concept, the important aspects of this particular topic, what we have chosen today, like allopathy drug-dependent cases. To my knowledge, in my little clinical experience of more than 40, 41 years, I have seen three types of cases. One, in which allopathic drugs cannot be stopped at all. You cannot stop. Second class of case, where allopathic drugs can be stopped, and ultimately, most of us. Third class of case, where allopathic drugs can be stopped abruptly. Now let's see. Drugs cannot be stopped at all. For example, we have seen a case, male aged 45 years. He was admitted to a corporate hospital with type 2 diabetes mellitus, accelerated hypertension, hyponatremia, and CRF. His complaints were frequent vomitings, shortness of breath, pain epigastrium, giddiness, loss of appetite, oliguria, and you can see there the BP was reading 210 by 120 mm of Hg. Accelerated, it is spiking, it is going up faster and faster. There is one more name or a classification which is called as a malignant hypertension, wherein the diastolic pressure is always above 140 mm of Hg. And there will be papilledema and other changes in the eyes also. That is a different class of case, malignant hypertension. We are not talking of that. We are talking of only accelerated hypertension. The blood urea was high, creatinine was 2.8, potassium was 4.6, sodium was less 100 milliequivalents. And nux vomica 200, cupramos 200 were given in 2 days span of time. because you can't take much time. There were hardly any characteristic features with this gentleman, and you can see a lot of anxiety with the attendants on their faces as well. So they could not give any relief. Then, taking a cue from the diagnosis of accelerated hypertension, so we could not stop any allopathic drug. Mind well, we cannot stop because already he is on a very volatile situation. He was in a very volatile situation, accelerated hypertension, and he could not have controlled his BP with any drugs possible. But if you stop, it can lead to any chaos. So at that time, adrenaline 6C, 6th hourly, Dr. Arana earlier mentioned very clearly, higher potencies cannot help. Fortunately, unlike in her case where 200 was giving some serious problems, and in this context, I should also mention my close friend, probably he may be there in the audience, Dr. Jayesh Sangvi from Chennai. He was after me, take the whole case, let us start homeopathic medicine. I did not tell him. And yesterday night also, he was on the phone and he was asking Aruna, what medicine do you take? What should be done? All these things. Then I told him, wait till tomorrow evening, you will know what is happening. No, probably it is clear to him. So unlike that situation, here 200 Naxformica, Cupramas 200 were given to this patient, but he did not have any aggravation. But the condition continued to be unabated, accelerated hypertension, which was more bothersome than any other situation. CRF you can wait, DM you can wait, but you can't wait for accelerated hypertension to take its own toll. So adrenaline 6C, 6th hourly, brought down the BP to 140 by 90 mm of Hg in 2 days' time. We all know it is very, very important. After that, when the, as she was mentioning, like the vital energy has been regained, then he could throw up his characteristic features, discuss clearly, then we could arrive at his drug of choice, lycopodium, and we have put him on lycopodium 0/1. He was very happy for 1 year or so, and then he left for abroad to his son's place. So we lost the contact. But till that time, he was absolutely good, all right, I should say. And you know, adrenaline, it is an extract of suprarenal bodies, adrenal glands, either tincture or trituration. Brief description. Its clinical uses are accelerated hypertension, Addison's disease, which is because of the adrenal deficiency, adrenal neuralgia, bronze skin, debility. In some of the cases, I tried giving adrenaline where they have these patches, melasma, such type of patches. I didn't get good relief with them, but I have succeeded with X-ray very well. So in those melasma cases, but this bronze skin prompted me to give adrenaline in certain inveterate cases, but could not help. Anyway, so hematuria, hyperemia, palpitation, tachycardia. These are the features of adrenaline. Adrenalinum is the remedy. Sarcode, it is a sarcode. Now let us come to case number two. The first case, as I have classified the cases which come to any practitioner, first variety where you cannot stop allopathic drugs. It is very difficult. It is like a live wire. Then the second case, a male aged 32 years, he came with complaints of burning urination, aggravation during and after. Pedal edema, dyspnea on exertion, profound weakness, loss of appetite, oliguria, he was constipated, personal history, sleep unrefreshed, thirst normal, sweat normal, he doesn't cover, desires sweets. Any guess what drug? He is a known case of CKD since 2008. He has given a report of USG abdomen in which acute renal parenchymal disease was there detected in 2008 and then went on to be diagnosed as CRF he was being treated for the past 2 years by allopathic drugs by nephrologist. He was advised dialysis as his serum creatinine crossed 7. Usually, when the parameter serum creatinine crosses, it depends on several other factors. EGFR is also calculated. That's very important. Proteinuria, several factors, but this is one such. He was told by his nephrologist, your creatinine crossed 7. You should be put on hemodialysis. No longer the medicines would help. So he was reluctant and more so afraid also. Who would be happy to go for dialysis? So there is a family history of CAD. For his father died. Mother, DM and HTN. He was initially given arsenicum album 0/1. Mind well, in 2010, my mindset was something different. Like when such type of cases wherein when they are in panic situation, when they are in anxious situation, so the physician is also put into that gear where we also become a little more anxious. So I used to give a 0/1, a tissue remedy, a mother tincture. It is a mixture. As she was talking about conjoint malady, so it is a conjoint prescription. All three together, three different prescriptions, three different drugs in three different forms. So it was given on 20th August 2010. This was the USG in 2008, grade 1 increased ecotexture of right kidney, acute renal parenchymal disease. Then later on he developed CRF. He was under the treatment as I already mentioned. So this is the report which was given, taken on 20th August, and he met me on 20th August itself with these reports where the serum creatinine was reading at 7.10 milligrams. Blood urea 129. So already crossed the borders, several borders, like it is surgical strike going into the capital. Now, so we have given these three drugs. With his anxiety, with his tension, worry, already he was given a warning by his nephrologist, at the earliest possible time you should be put on hemodialysis, come back early. So he waited for a week, took my medicines, did not stop the allopathic medicines, and he went for the investigation. Serum creatinine rose to 7.23, 0.1 to 0.23. So 0.13 increased. Marginal, it looks. But the urea has come down, but he is not bothered about urea. Urea, which was 129, came down to 93. He is not bothered. Then he gave me a ring. He said, this is the thing, sir. I am panicky. I am really afraid. What to do? Should I go for dialysis? All these things. And I said, yeah, do one thing. Stop all those three drugs. Go for arsenic album 6C. Arsenic was my drug of choice, depending on available data. Now, it is not my intention to teach you how to take the totality, how to select the arsenic album. That is not my intention now. My intention, or Dr. Aruna's intention, is to show you that we come across so many types of cases wherein they are dependent on allopathic drugs and we will be afraid whether to touch allopathic prescription or not, what to do. This is what we are trying to tell you. So arsenic 6C was advised. He took that from the shop. He took it and he used for almost 3 weeks. And then the test was done where the creatinine fell down to 4.43 on 13th September. 27th August, 13th September. So less than 2 weeks time, rather. It is not 3 weeks. Less than 2 weeks time, it came down. He was very happy. And he's a Muslim gentleman. He was on the border, rather. Make me all right a little. I will do something, gymnics, and push off to Gulf. That's what he did. He was put on arsenic in different potencies. Final dose was arsenic 0/1. I have given him 6 months medicine. And dialysis was averted. Many of his drugs were weaned off. He was barely on any allopathic medications when he left for Gulf with 6 months medicine. And after that, probably from 2012, there is no connection with this gentleman. Hopefully he should be all right there. So this is what, like, second type of case, second class of variety, what I have mentioned. First, where you cannot touch or drop the allopathic drugs. Second, where you have to introduce your drugs, as he has already said, like slowly and steadily with lower potencies, build up the potency, increase his resistance power, his susceptibility, his vital energy, then go to the higher potencies. And then depending on the necessity, maybe intercurrent, maybe complementary, maybe some other drug if needed. But he did not require any other medicine because he was improving with arsenic itself. And then you can slowly and steadily, in fact, his own nephrologist started weaning off many medicines, dropped when his BP was normal, his creatinine dropped down to less than 2, all these things, no edema, nothing. So that was one second class of case in this case. Then we will come to case number 3. This gentleman, 23-year-old, he was coming from a village, a town 100 kilometers away from Hyderabad by motorbike, met with an accident, and he went into coma. Severe head injury, and he was shifted to Gandhi Hospital, a government hospital in Hyderabad. And there they have given up and said, you take him to some corporate hospital, he will not survive. So they have shifted into a corporate hospital, and it was diagnosed as a case of subdural hematoma with diffuse axonal injury, diffuse. So he was in KIMS for about 67 days and spent 6 lakhs towards the treatment. 67 days during 2009, 6 lakhs was very high. And for this gentleman, very low middle class, or you can say lower class gentleman doing some small job. ESI gave some money, his parents sold off something. All these things could come up to 67 days. Probably the parents were waiting, he would die, let us see. But he did not. This is what, like, the destiny and fate. So this is the radiological impression, subdural hematoma, herniation, effacement, hemorrhage, fractures, hemosinuses, whatnot. The complex of all the things because of a severe head injury. Now, he was there for 67 days, and on 15th August, he was discharged from the hospital in absolute comatose condition because first the hospital felt no longer the patient's attendants could pay the money. Second, nothing could happen in 67 days. What will happen later? All these things put together, they just gave one B complex and one crocin and said, if you want to give, give, otherwise don't give. So this is third class of case where abruptly stopped. Now in this scenario, usually we will be scared to stop because he might die, but they have already given up and people are thinking that let him die, okay, leave it. So this was the scenario. He was brought in this bed sheet on 15th August to the clinic, and he was put on our examination couch, brought. And what that I know, that he became very lean, emaciated, and he was there, declared he would die any moment. So he was still in coma, unable to move, talk, or respond to commands. Absolutely comatose condition. This was the scenario. So what to do? All the medicines have stopped. Now he was sent home with very few allopathic drugs, almost like that prescription as I already said. And so they have stopped the treatment. He was put on arnica. I started with NM. There may be a question. I'll wait for that question. 50 M and CM in infrequent doses. And Bothrop's 10M was also given in 2 times in 2 weeks period. With a 2 weeks gap, I have given Bothrop's lanceolators 10M. The miracle, one fine day, they have forgotten, the parents. He was put on the bed in the room, in the front room, and people were doing their own work. They are weavers from Sirsila town. And they were doing their job, they have to, because that is the only the livelihood. The mother was doing some work and suddenly she heard Amma. That Amma, when she heard, she had shock of her life. When she looked back, the son started speaking on a very fine day. This was 14th November picture, similar type, but there is a little opening of the eyes. There is some putting on weight. And this is what, like 15th August, 14th November, he is still alive. What they thought he would die. We cannot predict who would die at what time. Right? Then, after 2 months of homeopathic treatment, so he started talking. We have followed up from time to time. Within 3 months, he became perfectly normal with not much of residual disabilities. Here, this case. Now, this gentleman came to my monthly clinic in Karimnagar. He was sitting among all the public. This was a photo taken by the pharmacist there. And you can't even imagine this. Here, it is not that a comatose patient has been cured. But here, what I wanted to tell you, that we can introduce our remedies when all the roads are closed. I have told earlier also in one of our NGH webinars, when allopathy fails, naturopathy helps. When naturopathy helps, fails, homeopathy helps. And when homeopathy fails, Tirupathy helps. So go to Tirupathy just before last journey. So this is how he became all right. Here I tell you, actually, before Corona struck India, if I remember well, in January 2020, this gentleman came to my clinic and his complaint was, this is a big question to all the audience. I would be very happy if you suggest me medicines, because I'm throwing open the question to you in reverse. You should ask me questions. You can ask me later. This gentleman came with only one single symptom. His recent memory is lost. I asked him, who am I? He told, you are my doctor, Praveen Kumar. You gave me life. I am alive. All these things he told. Then I asked, what did you have in the morning as breakfast? I don't know. So he cannot remember the recent one, Gajani. That Gajani movie, what you have seen, Aamir Khan. Similar to that, he forgets the recent ones and remembers. Repertory, you have got graphites, Rustox, all these things. But think of things, what drug can be given. It is not just one rubric, the past history and all these things. We have given the remedy, but that I request you to give me the suggestion. This is how we have done. Now, so anyway, I thought Dr. Aruna would conclude. But anyway, as we are talking, like 8 o'clock, we can? Or you want me to discuss? No. So
we have time, sir. We have time, sir. 10 minutes more to discuss. Right.
Now, here, one very important aspect. Most of the times, what happens to a neophyte? I'm not against anybody, any senior practitioner bringing up as a cult and educating people, do this, do that, and all that. Fine. But go according to Organon, because that is our Bhagavad Gita. Follow it by letter and spirit. You will not fail. Even if you fail, at least you know why did you fail. Otherwise, we will be groping in darkness. Otherwise, we make the same mistakes again and again and again and again. That's number one. Number two, I'll tell you one small example. One DGM of SBI went to a practitioner, well-established practitioner, and he follows his guru. That's what I said, like a cult. And this DGM was already diagnosed to have CRF. He was put on Dietar 100 mg. He was put on antihypertensives. He was put on insulin. He was put on some other remedies. I don't know the remedies names. Dr. Assani sir is there. He can tell you. So those are all the remedies, drugs, of allopathic drugs, which he was already on. And he was having severe hypertension, pedal edema, CRF was not getting controlled. And he was already on hemodials. At that point of time, when this gentleman, on advice of some manager, he went to this practitioner and he took the whole case. He spent a lot of time with him, took the whole case, and he said, I am giving you this beautiful remedy, one dose, and stop all your medicines and dialysis immediately. This DGM was in a very utter shock. Should I stop? Yeah. He asked three times. Stop it immediately. My medicine is like a magic. Take it. You'll be all right. So that day, he was having a lot of apprehension. That night, evening he took. Next day morning, he started developing breathlessness. Edema started increasing. Usually, if you see in the discharge summary of most of the CRF patients, it is given as on maintaining hemodialysis, maintenance hemodialysis. Like you maintain certain parameters, certain general condition with the help of hemodialysis. Hemodialysis is nothing but kidney functioning outside in a machine form. So that is also stopped. The drugs are stopped. Everything was stopped. So his BP was shooting up. He was checking with an electronic sphygmomanometer. At that point of time, when this was happening, then he called him next day evening. Then this doctor, he said, no, I'll ask my guru. I have given the right drug, but I need a suggestion. But this gentleman waited for one more day. It was becoming worse day by day. And that gentleman, when he was contacted, he said, my guru was not available. Then he got panicky. He went back to his nephrologist. Dialysis was done. Nephrologist scolded, abused. All these things happened. For 1 year, he did not even touch the name of homeopathy. 1 year. After 1 year, somebody told, again, he came to me. He asked me first question. Sir, should I stop all that allopathic procedure, medicine, hemodialysis, after I start? I said, we cannot stop abruptly. We have to wean off later when once I take over your constitution. So he was happy. That's how we taper off. Not to make him happy, I told this. But only to show that there is a lot of dependency. And you all know very well in Hahnemann's lesser writings, Hahnemann writes about the dependency. One beautiful experience. I'm not talking of allopathic drug. In fact, he did not speak of an allopathic drug. But he spoke of a lady. He goes to a lady. He takes the whole case and tells her the medicine. He gives the medicine. Gave the medicine. He came back. And after some time, went back to that same lady. When he went back, the lady became very weak. Hahnemann had surprise. What is this? How could she become like this when I have given a right remedy? What made her to become like this? When he inquired, she was accustomed to take wine every day, which she stopped on the advice of Hahnemann. Then Hahnemann said, oh, Mataji, immediately start karo. So he had to tell her to start wine. If you ask Dr. Rama Hariharan to stop coffee, she will stop talking to NJH. So this is how like we are addicted to. When we are dependent on certain things, you have to probably, most of the times, taper them off. Take the whole constitution into consideration, taper them off, and slowly and steadily, you can stop them. And the best example I can give you is hypothyroidism. Many of our cases, hypothyroidism cases, we stop those eltrogzins or thyronorms after a certain period of treatment. When once we start the treatment, we slowly take the stock of that situation. They are already, yesterday one gentleman came, he is already on 200 micrograms of eltrogzin, and the endocrinologist said, this is highest, I can't give anything, but now do you do? fifth edition of Argonaut, he would have read, I don't know that endocrinologist, he told him, dissolve it in water and take one teaspoonful every fourth hour. This is like fifth edition Hahnemann told water doses. So he told 200 mcg eltroxin, maybe two tablets, 100 mcg, I don't know. So that has to be dissolved in a glass of water and should be taken. That is the situation of this gentleman. His TSH is not getting controlled. His symptoms are not getting controlled. So at that point of time, we have introduced a remedy yesterday and told him, okay, continue to do that. And after 1 month, you check your TSH. Depending on your condition and TSH, we slowly taper off that 200 later on. That's how we have done to many patients. But not in a great hurry. So that is what, like, that is our humble request to all the fraternity of homeopathy, that when once you get a case, most of the cases are coming with bundle of reports, lot of prescriptions, and you have to know them. And as she already told, like conjoint malady, how do you know whether this symptom has been developed by allopathic drug or is it its original symptom, disease symptom? We should also have a little knowledge. Otherwise, nowadays, Google Mama is there. Search in Google. You will get the information. What is the side effect of that remedy that would have produced? Yesterday, serum alkaline phosphatase raised for a boy. And that mother sent me through WhatsApp only that LFT report and said, sir, it is in a dangerous situation. Do you have a remedy? I said, for whom? For what? So when I inquired, this boy is already on AKT and that anti-cox treatment, that drug, is hepatotoxic and it produces this. Now you should know this. Then we know, yes, this is because of that. What to do? Then we will know that. So that's how we have to understand whether the symptom is because of the disease or because of the drug. Both put together, if you treat slowly and steadily, the patient comes into a stage where he would accept homeopathic doses perfectly. That's how we can do it. So as Close beautifully puts it, in terminal stages and in malignant conditions, it is always better to start with lower potencies. Why? This is also very important. There is a dictum in potency selection. Dr. Ajit should be there. He wrote a book on potency also. Where higher the number of characteristics, higher the potency. Now, in such type of terminal stages and cancer cases, obviously, characteristic features would be very, very minimal. So you can't think of higher potency. You have to definitely go for a lower potency. That's how Close wrote there. But when pathogenetic symptoms of the crude drugs, maybe like allopathic, maybe like Ayurvedic drugs, because ours are dynamized or potentized drugs. So all the rest of the drugs are crude drugs. If they develop, it is better to resort to higher potencies to nullify their bad effects. This is a very important aspect which we have to remember. If there is a side effect because of an allopathic drug, which is bothering the patient more, and if you can counter that symptom with an antidote, give it in higher potency, it would come down. And higher potencies can also be very useful in very terminal conditions, like the case what I have shown, the coma, where the fellow would have died. So we have started with 10 mg. I have not given 6, 30, 200, no patients, nothing. Right? And there was one case presented by Dr. S.M. Singh from Allahabad. And he showed us beautifully, if you open Borix Materia Medica under Carbovege, it is given very clearly that in terminal stages where you have to give Carbovege, potencies. So it works well in one such case where the patient was admitted to ICU. It was almost like give up situation. At that stage, Dr. S.M. Singh gave Carbovege in CM potency and the patient became all right. So such type of experiences would tell us, and this is already given there, if the allopathic drugs have spoiled or the crude drugs have spoiled and it is at that stage, then probably you may have to give higher potencies. However, when you go hand in hand with allopathic system of medicine, it is preferable to start with lower potencies and gradually increase as and when required. This is the essence of whole presentation. Slowly start with low potency, slowly increase, see the reaction from the patient, and then steadily and slowly you can help. Recently, one patient was admitted with COVID-19 in a corporate hospital, and he was under treatment in the corporate hospital itself, and his son slowly developed sinusitis, and it was diagnosed as fungal sinusitis. In one Telegram Tuesday case, I have presented one fungal sinusitis case. It is not that. This is a recent one. This gentleman, it was referred by a doctor from Guntur. So this gentleman, he had one beautiful symptom. Those attendants and patient, they themselves were homeopathic aligned people. So they knew one symptom. This patient, in spite of being in a corporate hospital and being under treatment and all that, so he was telling the attendants, his wife or his son, cut my third hand. There is a third hand which is causing a lot of damage to my body. Cut my third hand. Where is the third hand? So it is a delusion. And if they were talking anything, he was getting a snapshot type of anger, and he was shouting at them, throwing the things onto their faces. What remedy should we give? Anyway, all of you would have been muted. So it is not a classroom. So I have given stramonium. Petroleum is also a remedy where the delusions of somebody, some limbs and all that. But stramonium, because of anger and this delusion, both are there in stramonium. Stramonium has started with 30, 200, 1 ml. Without much gap, within 12 hours, 200, 1 ml. The patient got discharged, went back home, and then I told that doctor who referred to me, take care. So this is how it would be useful when they throw some characteristic feature. But it is not easy, all the cases, because most of the cases which are under allopathic treatment for a long time, it will be suppressed and you don't get any characteristic features. So this is how we have to be careful when we are taking cases hand in hand with allopathic drugs. So thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. It is right at time you have banged up, and this presentation has really gone spellbound to all the audience, because long back I have put a message that if there are any questions, you can ask. But sir, absolutely, if we ask students that are there any questions, and then there are no questions, then we think either the students have understood everything or they have not understood anything.
Yeah.
In your case, I'm very much sure that all the participants have understood all whatever you have said, and your wisdom, right from the adrenaline craze to the subdural hematoma and giving potencies from 10 mg, 50 mg, cm and Bothrops, and having rescued the patient from right from comatose to life. So hats off to you, sir. We want to hear more and more, but as the time says that we have to end with our presentation, and there are many questions, and it would be a very right if Sir Asrani sir is there. He could comment on this as his own opinion, because the is such, like, it is an allopathic. We have a Doyen from our NJH group. Yes, sir.
Dr. Asrani, please.
Asrani sir is there. Sir, please, we would like you to come on the screen and share your words of wisdom.
Just give me a minute.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Till then, if we can take some few questions from the chat box, if they are there. Mainly from the participants and not from Asrani sir at present.
Any questions? chart. There are 18 so charts.
I told you, no, the students are all well learned now. Yes, sir. Sani sir is there.
So
yes, sir.
I had a question to Dr. Aruna.
Sir,
did you get hypertension, diabetes due to pneumonia, as you said?
No. Sir, it was after swine flu, sir.
Diagnosed.
It was diagnosed after swine flu. Simultaneously, so, when I had
two of the diseases, you got new after the swine flu.
Yes, sir.
And you don't have a family history. You were never pre-diabetic, nothing.
No, sir.
Because even on the bigger list of swine flu complications,
sir,
developing diabetes, hypertension is not listed.
But that's exactly what the consultants told me, sir. And I developed these only after I was diagnosed with swine flu, sir.
And you are still a diabetic?
I am on insulin. Now my sugar levels and the BP are under control, sir. Most of my antihypertensives have been weaned off. I'm on a minimal dosage, sir. Both on insulin and antihypertensive, sir.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
So I was very happy when I heard the topic of this today's webinar.
Sir.
Because most young homeopaths very clearly tell the patient, first you go, stop all allopathy and then come to me. So I always say that you or anybody, like today, I don't know the effect of homeopathy and effect of a 50 mg or a 20 mg or a cm. I cannot tell a patient, no, don't take that.
Sure.
And we never do.
Yeah.
So at least talk to the doctor who's treating, if you have confidence that you can stop the medicines, and then take a call on stopping medicine. See, other than painkillers, according to me, no other medicine can be stopped stat, even antibiotics.
Yes, sir.
Because if you stop antibiotics also stat, okay, from today you stop, then people develop antibiotic resistance for future. And everybody is free to take whatever therapy they want to take.
Correct.
Secondly, I would at this time take this opportunity to suggest that homeopathy seniors who are trying to treat hypertension only by homeopathy alone should also do little research project, because we today, if a patient tells me, no, that my BP is controlled, can I stop medicine? So our medicines today are not for controlling BP. They are for organ protection. They protect kidney, they protect heart. Can we expect similar results with homeopathy if a proper study could be done? No, then that would help a lot. That in addition to bringing down the blood pressure reading, can we also give organ protection? Then I will be willing to answer any question if somebody has about allopathy medicine. I think your talks have been very, very convincing to people.
Thank you, sir.
So that there are no questions.
They did not expect that it would be of her only.
Maybe people were expecting that you will say that stop allopathy ASAP.
No, sir. In fact, so I learned.
They're still recovering from the shock.
Yeah, I learned, sir, that sometimes you have to go hand in hand with allopathy.
And I always say that other than steroids and morphine, opium, you can give all remedies together.
Yes, sir. So this is a great knowledge for us. And we hope that our participants also gets benefit with sir's view. And we all practice in our pathy as well as take hand in hand in allopathic mode of treatment and conjointly help patients.
There are some questions, it seems.
Yes, some one question is there. I will pin you, sir, first.
Somebody asked me, why have you given 50M frequently? I have not given 50M frequently, but I don't mind giving 50M frequently to a patient who is in comatose condition, who is not responding at all. 50M CM doesn't matter because he was given up. So, I would be very happy to give also. I didn't give to this man. I have given 10M, 50M, CM. Hardly within 2 months, I have given both drops also. Hardly within 2 months, he started speaking. He was improving. When he started improving, I did not give any medicine. It was all SM. That is the reason why I said recently, I can't say recently, 1.5 years back, he came with this particular recent memory loss, which was not there at that time when he became all right. He developed very recently. This has happened only in 2020. This case was of 2009 or something like that. 2009.
So since there are no questions coming, can I ask you one question?
Yeah, please.
So from the first case which adrenaline was given for the CKD, have you tried other organ remedies like eel serum or the routine medicines which we always
give? I have not given to this gentleman because I have based my adrenaline prescription basing on the most bothersome problem at that point of time, accelerated hypertension. But eel serum I have given to quite a number of patients of renal failure. I have given Punarnava also. Punarnava in mother tincture form is a very, very Borivia diffuser, very useful drug. Cupramars is a very wonderful drug in CRF cases. We have got quite a number of CRF cases which respond very well. That is another point to discuss. Like there are three classes of cases where one would go for dialysis, one would go for transplant, one would doesn't want to go for dialysis. All these types of cases, depending on that necessity, we have to select which potency, which drug, at what time, and then slowly and steadily, as the days progress, they will develop some characteristic features, and we might select a constitutional remedy, and we slowly give higher potencies to those people.
Yes, sir. And one more question you had asked that I hope somebody asked in the chat box, but there were no questions. So, Arnica, why Arnica 10M?
Hiremath asked what is the dosage of Punarnava. Usually I give Punarnava mother tincture 10 drops in half cup of water 3 times a day if there is no contraindication. That's how usually I give. Yeah, another, sorry, I interrupted. You were talking about Arnica?
Yes.
What was that?
Why Arnica was given in 10M potency?
That's what I said, like there was a situation where I have to arouse some response because it is almost like a dying situation. Arouse some response. And this, I already told you, when you read carbovage, like in such a type of terminal conditions where there is no response, no reaction, give a higher potency. So I have given higher potency, Arnica 10. Did not help. Gave 50M, did not help. CM, both drops. But one thing I tell you, as somebody was narrating very beautifully, if a gold thread is cut after 100th hit by a hammer, all 99 were not wasted. Those 99 were necessary. So Arnica 10M, 50M, CM, both drops, all these things, all put together, slowly and steadily, the patient has improved. And mind well, I have seen him only 2 times before he could speak. I have seen him in such a condition where he was brought in a bed sheet. That was the condition. So there was no other characteristic which had nothing to depend on. Head injury, went into coma, severe problem, severe hemorrhage, fracture, everything. So Arnica, let us give. Let's see. So that's yes, like I tell you.
Fantastic explanation. Now, as we are close to our webinar, I would like Madam, Vishpala Madam, to come on the screen and give her words of wisdom. I'll pin her.
So I think we have had a very, very good discussion. And my dog also wants to add his two bits to it. So he says he was very happy with the webinar and he likes the way homeopathy treats him. And really, it is a very good topic because I know lots of times many homeopaths just say stop the drugs and it is not possible. It should not be done. And so many patients die, but that is not reported. Only the successes are reported. And everything, today's topic was really good because they gave three types of cases and how you can handle each thing differently. So, and anyway, the medicines work at different levels. So there is just no clash and there should be no reason to stop anything immediately. As you get results, of course, you can taper off and or continue. In some life-saving drugs, which are possible, and especially where you require a patient to, their commitment. Sometimes they don't come for our medicines so frequently properly. And then where you are required for diabetes, for heart, for hypertension, you require to be taking doses and which are available anywhere you're traveling. You should take lot of care to see that you don't stop those drugs. And only when you get results, you should do that. So I'm really thankful to the doctors today. All three of you have done a great job. And Dr. Asrani, in convincing people that everything, finally, we are there for helping the patient. And we can say our system, their system, there is no fight. We should carry on and go ahead with seeing how the patient responds best. Of course, if he's responding, he's keeping stable, you can and do. We do taper off. Even we have thyroid cases, hypertensive cases, where people are just keeping normally, then you can taper it completely. So thank you so much for
thank
our
you. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. Last question, I think Rajendra Hiremit sir has asked, arousing when vital force is at low web, when lot of gross pathology, that is terminal end stage, is that, sir? A last question we can take up.
That's what Rajendra Hiremit, he put there. I wanted to, but when it was wound up, I thought, okay. That's what I said, like, when you see exactly what that earlier close has said, like when the pathology is at lowest ebb, you start with lower potency and all that. Here, one, Carbovege has helped that description in Boric. Two, already gave up. There was no chance of anything. So, it was an acute condition, very acute condition, where the healthy person met with an accident, went into a condition. It was not with any past history, any disease progressing into this stage. So that type of condition, you can start with a higher potency and then it would definitely help to arouse the response from the patient. And it helped. It would help.
Yes, sir. So correctly said, folks. We have attended such a beautiful webinar and I'm sure that all the participants are satisfied with our answers and with your queries. I appeal one and all that you joined our NJH family through Telegram, through Facebook, through YouTube, through our journal and
become life members.
And so become life members, yes.
Everything. Yes. I have one last thing to say is that I make it a rule to advise everyone I know, not only patients and us, that there is the remedy Arnica in any potency should be with you all the time in your purse, because you never know when you will fall, when somebody else will fall. And the quicker you give it, the better response you get. Exactly. I have saved so many lives like this because I always have it in my purse, in my car, in wherever. And I give it, all my patients have it in their purses. And I tell my acquaintances who are not my patients also, this is one remedy you should have with you 24/7. You never know when it is useful. You just fall, take it, and you will be better within hours. minutes, whatever. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So have a good evening, good night, and a lovely forthcoming Saturday, scintillating Saturday. Wait for it. We will bang it off.
Okay.
Bye. Good night. Thank you.